Hello everybody and welcome to another map first impressions video. Today we're going to take a look at a Russian map named Berezovka, I believe. This is version 2.1 of this map, and I found it up on modhub.us, and there will be a link to the map in the description. So in the description at modhub it says this is a Russian map. It's a small but very nice map. There are two points of sale. There is a forest. There are 7 fields, of which you own 1. And there is another field that is marked as a meadow. So, there it is. Let's jump in and take a look. So, with normal first impression videos that I do, I like to pick my John Deere Gator. And we'll use that to drive around the map. We also pull up our log here. See, you can ignore these two warnings. Here we've got a couple errors related to the map. A couple image files. Okay, that appears to be the only issues with the log. Oops. Sorry about that. I started somewhere around here, I know. I'm guessing we started in here, because I saw some of this texture before I incorrectly hit tab instead of the tilde to close out the log. So let's take a look at the map. Okay, so here we are. We've got 7 fields as promised. We own fields 1 and field 8, which is a grass meadow. Sorry about that. Let's pick these back. I had these turned off from another video I was running. So it looks like we start here toward the middle. Their chickens are here. It looks like our animals are all in distinct areas. So let's take a look at our starting fleet. So we start with a Fleetor 75 horsepower tractor. We start with a small Sampo harvester, a grain header, a small tipper, a cultivator, and a small seeder. So the cultivator says it needs 125 horsepower, 120, but our tractor is only 75, but it may pull it as long as it's got flat terrain. Let's pick up our gator. And we'll let's look at the shop. Okay. There's the gator. So let's reset this. Let's see where it goes. So the gator, the reset point is at the shop. Alright, that is our customization area to customize our vehicles. So you don't want to return that. Let's jump back here to our start point. Here we have our chickens. This appears to be just a neighbor's house. Okay, Okay, so we, the walls, some of these walls don't appear to have collisions on them. We just kind of walked through the walls there. Nice wood pile. I'm not really sure what that is. It's a pile of something. A pile of hay or a pile of grass or something there. So at the career start point, the only thing we have here is our harvester. Looks like we may have pulled up the harvester here and parked it as we were, you know, in our house eating our lunch or something. So let's run up the way here. It looks like our sheep are just across the water here. Looks like here we may be able to back down and get water. It's a little steep, but it looks like we may be able to back in here and pull up our water for our sheep. Here's our feed trough and our water trough for our sheep. See if we can figure out where we buy our sheep. Okay. Oh. Sorry guys, I got distracted for something. I knew something was off. So we have all the normal crop types on this map. Two sell points. I start these map first impression videos on hard, so we start with zero crops in the silos. It looks like there isn't a place to sell our straw, hay, or grass. At least it's not showing up here on our prices screen. All of the equipment we have is new, so we have fairly low maintenance. I realized I hadn't done this because I didn't have enough money to buy our animals. So I like to take out a loan here so that we'll have money when we get around to the various buy places. We start with zero animals and nothing in the various feed areas. And our silo has a capacity of 100,000 liters. All right, so there's our sheep in our little pen here. Not really sure where the wool spawns. And honestly, I don't know if this would show the wool spawn point or not. I've never tried to figure out where the wool spawn point is based on that. Yeah, this has a very big trigger around it, and it has hay, straw, our grass and straw here. So I'm wondering, this may be like a sell point for these. It's just not marked on the map as to what the prices are. Let's see if we can get up on top of this. No, we just go through it, okay. So our sheep area has this shed, pull-through storage shed that we could store our wool before we sell it, or we could store our equipment in there related to our sheep production. Right across from the sheep, we have a buy point for eggs. So like I said, I'm not really sure where the wool is going to spawn here in our sheep area. It would make sense to me if it spawned right here, but it may not. So let's run up here and check out the price of field 6 and see if we have missions, and then we're going to jump in our gator. So we do have missions, and field 6 is 4.10 hectares, $300,000. So that's a not bad price. With respect to other fields, field 6 seems to be a mid-sized field. Field 5 and 4 and 3 are bigger. 7 is bigger, but fields 1 and 2 are smaller, and field 1 is the field that you own. So there doesn't appear to be a shop building per se. It's more of a parking spot with a repair point beside a square box of some sort. All right, so here's one of our sell points. Looks like we've got some product they kind of look like peanuts. I think it's supposed to be wheat. So let's see where we are. Sorry guys, I'm trying to figure out which sell point we are at. That's wood chips. Are we at a wood chip factory? Or this one? I'm guessing this particular sell point takes all of your normal crops. Should be a All right. This looks to be the sell point for wood chips. You just dump your wood chips here. Looks like across the street here we have an animal buy point. So here's our animal buy point. Should you wish to purchase animals and drive them back to your farm yourself? Big old rock there. I've not seen that model used before. So field 7 is 4.8 hectares, 388,000. It's like another spot where you could pull down and get free water. And here we have our pig area. So our solid manure is there. Our liquid, our slurry, comes out here. This is our cattle area. Let's buy some cows. Here's our silage bunker. It's recessed down in the ground with some concrete looking walls. So here we have our cattle pen. Water and grass trough here. I'm assuming that the cattle can go in here. I'm not seeing any triggers. This appears to be a trigger. So our feed, our TMR, this feed trough here on the right appears to be activated with a trigger. So this is one of our feed areas. I suppose the cattle can make their way through here. But these feed areas do not appear to be activated in any way. So let's go here and take a look at our pigs. So our buy point for pigs. This building appears to be just decoration. So here's our pigs. This must be where we put our straw point. We have a feed trough there. Do we have water on the opposite side? Yes, we do. Okay, so that's our... This is our pig area. Let's see if these do anything. No, these are just decoration. So everything related to the pigs is between these two long buildings. Okay. There's the icon. Yeah, the icon up there. For the bale, for hay straw sales, is there. Now, of course, it's not listed here. There are no prices here. The barn's not listed. So, let's see here. Let's jump back in our gator. And let's run up here. Let's check out the grass meadow, field 8. Okay, here's our slurry point for our pigs. We didn't find that earlier, did we? And our solid manure for our pigs is there. Okay, now we're driving through our forestry area for doing forestry. And here we are, field 8. Wrong button, sorry. So here we are, very large grass meadow to support our cows and our sheep operations, as well as to maybe bale up silage bales for money. Field 2, and we're going to be approaching field 1 shortly. So let's take a look up here and see what we got. This should be our main farm. Okay. We have icons that kind of indicate that we've got some equipment here. So we have a nice storage shed here. One of our walls has fallen over. That's a nice interesting element. A nice pond here with our cattails blowing in the wind. Here we have some storage. It looks like these may be designed for you to tip into. Here we have a wall, a door that's kind of fallen off the hinge or off the rail. Here's a marker for something. Not really sure if this is supposed to be our silos. And it kind of looks like silo storage. This looks like these are possibly seed or fertilizer bags. They're just decoration. And these really look like these could be our silos, but I don't see where there's a silo out point. There's a pipe that's going that way. I don't know if this is our silo tip in. It's very interesting setup. Some product on the ground here. I don't know if that's to indicate that one of these, if this is our silo out area, it may be indicating that this particular spot is where we it is. Okay, so here we have our tip trigger, so we would pull our trailer underneath this particular one right here, and we would get a fill message. So I am guessing, based on that this is our tip in, that we just dump it on the ground and it magically shows up in the silo. We have a sinkhole here. Some more retaining walls that are falling over. This tree has fallen over, knocked that wall over. So that's a cool little element. Yeah, that's nice. I like that. Here we have the rest of our starting equipment. We have our cultivator and our seeder. Okay. The doors don't seem to operate. Here we have our tractor and our small tipper. So this whole area here is our main farmyard. And here we have some houses and some whatnot across from the main farm. So these may be fields or maybe areas that we can plant and harvest. Let's check, see if they show up as being needing plowed. They show up as being cultivated. So it looks like we could make use of these areas if we wanted to plant some crops in those. Of course, we would have really low yield out of those, basically based on size. But since things like sugar beets have a fairly high yield for the size of field that you plant, and the need for sugar beets is fairly low by the pigs. The pigs don't use many sugar beets or potatoes. You could probably plant potatoes or sugar beets in those little garden-like spaces. So this is an interesting structure over here, kind of up on a hill. Sorry, I had a little keyboard problem here. I really don't know if this is supposed to be like a church structure or something else, why it would be up here on a hill like this. You know, it looks like it would be, you know, a structure kind of like, you know, the first person that settled here or basically made this place their home, basically built this house on a rise so they could see, you know, the countryside around. And has since forth, you know, left or sold the properties off to others. So here we have the field one that we own. Field three and field four. Let's go see how big field four is. So field four is 11.4 hectares and $900,000. All right, so we just need to make our way up here to these two sell points. Looks like we have a road coming up. Okay, so we can follow this road around. We have not gone into here. Oh no. Oh, that's great. All right. So we'll just leave that abandoned. And this looks like this may be our sawmill. here. Alright, I'm not seeing any active triggers for anything. So it may just be decoration. That is a massive tree. Seems to be buried in the ground, but that would have been a massive tree. Okay, this appears to be some more of the farm of our main farm that we just didn't see before. Here we have a fallen silo. Broken down tractor body. So this map has lots of decoration, decor, decorative elements. To really give you that Slavic type feel, you know, it's kind of you know, run down, bedraggled, dare I say, post-apocalyptic type setting. Alright, this might be our sawmill. I mean, we have forestry. We should have some place to sell our logs, right? We found where we could sell our wood chips. But I'm not seeing a sell point for logs. Alright, here's where we started, and our chickens. We have our sheep, and our hay sales over there. That appears to just be a nice country, little country house estate there that's right on the river. That goes back to the big field. Here we've got the river, we've got a kind of where we can drive through the river. We have what looks like a train car without any wheels. No train tracks anywhere to be found. Oh. Spoke a little too soon on that. Here's the train. So it looks like we, here's our wool sell point. This is not a drivable train or a send-offable train. And it looks like you just tip into the here, and then the conveyor would take it up and deposit it in the train car to obviously eventually go off to market. So those are the last two buy points. So that's the map, guys. This is Berezovka version 2.1. Again, it's up on modhub.us, and there will be a link in the description. Thanks for watching.